Hello guys, myself Manasa and I am Miracle Manasa and I am studying in the class of 9th Techno. I am from Chittoor branch. Today my topic is Archimedes Principle and the proof of Archimedes Principle. And before explaining you the Archimedes Principle, let me explain you about who is Archimedes. Archimedes is a Greek mathematician and inventor who invented our law. And what is our law? Our law is Archimedes Principle. Archimedes Principle states that when an object is totally or partially immersed in a fluid, it experiences an upthrust equal to the weight of the fluid displaced. And here, let me explain you about upthrust or buoyant force. I have an example for you. You can take a container filled with a liquid and a plastic ball which is weightless, or you can use even an air balloon which is filled with air. When you try to push the ball or the air balloon downwards, you can feel some force pushing the ball vertically upwards, and when you leave it, it bounces back. And what is the force that pushes the ball upward is nothing but upthrust or the buoyant force. And here I have one more example for you. Here, this is a block of aluminium. The volume of the aluminium is 100 centimeter cube and the density of the aluminium is 2.7 gram per centimeter cube and the mass of the aluminium is 270 grams and the weight of the aluminium is 2.7 newtons. And when this aluminium is placed in a liquid, its volume is 100 centimeter cube and density is 1 gram per centimeter cube, mass is 100 grams, weight will be 1 newton. And next, when you see the reading of the spring balance, when it is in air, it's 2.7 newtons and when you see here, it's 1.7 newtons. In this figure, you can see that when compared to the first figure, in the second figure, the weight of the aluminium has lost its weight. This is due to upthrust or buoyant force. And here, let me explain you the formula of Archimedes Principle and the buoyant force. By the above below two examples, we got our formula is buoyant force is equals to weight of the liquid displaced. And weight formula, can I know what is the weight formula, friends? Yes, you are right. It's mg. And note that force is equals to mass into acceleration. And mass and density is equals to, density is represented by rho and rho is equals to mass by volume. By that we got rho vg, and the formula for buoyant force fb is equals to rho l vlg. Can you guess why I represented here l? It's easy for us to remember the formula, and it's nothing but rho l, density of the liquid, into vl, volume of the immersed liquid into density. And next, here I have buoyant force is also divided into three types. When the buoyant force is equal to the weight of the object, then the object floats completely above the liquid surface. And when buoyant force is equal to the weight, the object floats and it remains stationary. And when buoyant force is greater, when we saw in the before example, the object moves up, which means it completely floats above the liquid surface. And buoyant force is less than the weight of the object moves down, which means it sinks. Here I have law of flotation. Archimedes' principle is also called as law of flotation. A floating object displaces its own weight of the liquid when it floats. And here I have a question for you. If you observe this, all these four figures, the level of the water is different in each figure. Here the water is warm fresh water, whereas in the second figure, cold fresh water, and third warm sea water, and the next one cold sea water. Can you guess why the same ship is immersed in the four water levels, why it differs from each other? I have the solution for you, friends. Next. fresh water is less denser than the sea water, and warm water is less denser than the cold water. This is why the water levels are different in the each figures. And coming to the end of the part, the applications of Archimedes principle. We can see Archimedes principle in our day-to-day lives, and the best example to it is hot air balloon, and the next one is submarines, and the next one is hydrometer and lactometer. What is meant by hydrometer? It is an instrument used to measure the density of a liquid. And what do you mean by lactometer? Lactometer is the instrument which is used to measure the purity of a liquid. And one more application of Archimedes principle is, while we are swimming, we can see we float in the water. This is also a one more example for Archimedes principle. And I have a great mnemonic for you friends to remember the Archimedes principle very easily. And that is nothing but up word. You should just remember the word up, UPWOLD, and split it into two. That comes UP is equals to WOLD, and up is nothing but the upward force is equals to OLD. That is nothing but weight of the liquid displaced. And in this video, I have discussed about Archimedes principle. Laws of what is meant by Archimedes, who is Archimedes, and the Archimedes principle, upthrust and buoyant force, applications of Archimedes principle, and remember, I gave a great mnemonic to you. Thank you and keep smiling.